Nina Mani, Nina Mani, Tangu nipoke Bwana Yesu, Nina Mani. My name is Brian Mashigadi. Welcome to Life Series. Today we head on over to the book of Galatians, chapter 5, verse 22. We're looking at the fruit of the Spirit. And it says, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. And it says, against this, there is no law. Today, we look at this one attribute of the fruit of the Spirit, that is peace. Peace, what does it mean? Peace, I think, simply put, means the absence or freedom. Let's put it that way. Freedom from unrest, freedom from war, freedom from the things that could easily throw us off. And I love that definition because it has the word in it, freedom. Because when it has the word freedom in it, it means, therefore, that peace is not the absence of these things. It is not the absence of war. It is not the absence of unrest. But it is the freedom from these things. So it means that around us could be chaotic, but we are not bound by the chaos. We are not slaves to the chaos. We are free from it. So it is possible that everything around us could be falling apart. But if you have peace, then it means that you have freedom from the chaos that are around you. So easy for us to think of it, of that attribute of peace. In the words of Jesus Christ, in the book of Philippians, the words of Paul, in the book of Philippians, chapter 4, verse 6, talking about, do not be anxious for anything, but in all things through prayer and supplication, always make your requests known to God. It says, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds. The peace of God. The peace of God that surpasses all understanding. It means that even in things, through chaos, through things that could easily give us anxiety, through those things, when we make our requests known to God, then the result of it is peace. Brings us to another thing concerning the attribute of peace of the Holy Spirit. It makes me think about that peace is as a result of abiding. Just like the fruit, every attribute of the fruit of the Spirit, it is as a result of abiding. We don't work for it. The previous verses talk about the works of the flesh, but we don't work for it. It is as a result of abiding. You stay in Jesus. You abide in Him and He in you. Then you bear the fruit. And one of the attributes of that fruit is peace. It means that there could be chaos all around. You've lost a loved one, but there's this peace that cannot be understood. You yourself can also not understand. You should be falling apart and it looks like your life has come to an end. But then you have the peace of God that causes you to move on, to keep on moving. Does not mean that you're not grieving or that you're not mourning, no, but it means that there is peace inside of you. A peace, as the Bible puts it in the book of John chapter 14, a peace that the world cannot give, a peace the world cannot afford. It is a peace that only God can give. That is what peace is. Allow me to share with us something that Barclay says. It says that the word that is used here for Greek, for the word peace, is a word that is commonly known as Irene, which is where we get the name the ladies are called Irene. It means not just freedom from trouble, but everything that makes for a man's highest good. Therefore, here it means tranquility of heart, which is derived from the all-pervading consciousness that our times are in the hands of God. That's why I say it's as a result of abiding. So what is the posture of your heart today? Are you abiding in God? Because if you're abiding, I want to promise you, peace is a byproduct of abiding in God. God bless you.